Today we go over Star Wars Episode 9, the final film of the Skywalker saga and the sequel trilogy alike. This is Mike Zero here. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. Now, as you all know, Episode 9 is currently filming over in the UK, and after that they plan on filming over in Italy, Guilin, China, and quite possibly even Jordan. Now, looking at Episode 9, these past couple of weeks we have been learning a whole lot more about this movie. I wanted to get on the subject of Supreme Leader Snoke. It is a huge story right now. I don't know if you guys heard about it, but Andy Serkis actually just canceled an appearance at a con that he was supposed to appear at over in Philadelphia. Now, this is something very similar in a sense to what Billy Dee Williams did and Yunus Watamo, both of which who play, of course, Lando Calrissian and Chewbacca. Now, they actually canceled their appearances for Star Wars Episode 9 scheduling conflicts, and the same exact thing goes for Andy Serkis. He canceled from appearing at this con over in Philadelphia because he actually had to cancel due to scheduling conflicts. Now, this also lines directly up with a lot of the rumors and leaks out there suggesting of Snoke's return in Episode 9 in some way, shape, or form. We really don't know exactly how he's going to return. Most likely it will be done in the form of flashbacks and or holograms, maybe even visions, etc. Hopefully they do bring him back to life. That to me would be a shocker and would really make things all the more different in the sequel trilogy, catching us by surprise. But looking at an interview a couple months back with Slash Film, Andy Serkis had this to say, where he stated, "Look, it's Star Wars, so you never know how life or whether life can come back to or not, whether you can be resurrected or brought back. I was shocked dramatically. It felt absolutely right for that moment in the film. So I didn't question it. I just think it's a very, very important scene, so I didn't question it. But I do. I know it's left fans feeling like that they were really searching for something there. And what I'm saying is, who knows?" And that's what Andy Serkis had to say. Now, sometime well after that, he went over how there's already a backstory planned for Snoke. That's already done. He knows Snoke's backstory. He's not allowed to share it with anybody else. He, Rian Johnson, and J.J. Abrams have discussed Snoke's backstory. And one of the main reasons, apparently, as to why they left it out of The Last Jedi was to hold it in case they wanted to do a movie that involved, Supreme Leader Snoke, or maybe even a trilogy that would involve the character of Supreme Leader Snoke, maybe even a set of films telling us the events before The Force Awakens with a younger Ben Solo and a Snoke that we have never seen before. That to me would be pretty interesting for sure. But looking at Episode 9 here, this is a big hint of Snoke's return that Andy Serkis, just canceled his appearance at this con over in Philadelphia, and it was all due to scheduling conflicts, alright? So that was the actual reason. It was all due to scheduling conflicts, and it's very strange how this happened just as Star Wars Episode 9 is actually starting to shoot elsewhere. They're starting to actually go to more locations outside of Pinewood and Cardington, starting at the very end of September, leading into October. So they're entering a new phase of principal photography where they're going to be doing more and different scenes for different characters, of course. So I don't know what Andy Serkis is going to be doing in this movie, if he is indeed involved. It could very well be that something simple as maybe him portraying a different character. That's a possibility too, but I don't think so. I definitely do think that if Andy is involved, it is most definitely Snoke. Like I say, most likely scenario is a hologram, a vision, or a flashback. The thing that a lot of fans would love to see, I know some of you guys out there would hate to see this as well, is bringing him back to life in some way, shape, or form. To me, I think it would be a great way to turn Ben Solo to the light, where Snoke comes back as the main villain, and he poses a threat to Kylo Ren. The fact that he betrayed him, and now he wants Kylo Ren out, he wants to kill him. Maybe there's a moment in time in which they could actually point this out where, in Episode 9, both Rey and Kylo Ren have to team up to take on Supreme Leader Snoke, and that's essentially what turns Kylo Ren, right? You know, like, kind of like the enemy of my enemy is my friend situation in a Star Wars movie. That is something that I would love to see, where both Rey and Kylo have to team up to destroy this dark entity being Supreme Leader Snoke. But anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comments, and if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.